Hey trendsetters, it's your girl Deanna Nicole. Welcome back to my channel, and today I am bringing you this tutorial on how to do these beautiful color highlights. I also will be showing you how I use my sewing machine to make this wig and the process that I went through in order to get these different color browns in my wig. So just stay tuned and keep watching. Hey trendsetters, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Deanna Nicole. Make sure you tap that like and that subscribe button and that bell so you can get new notifications on when I drop exclusive videos just like these. And yeah, we're gonna get into this hair, period. This hair is by FDX. It's a company on AliExpress, and I wanted to try it because I wanted something new. And it was on sale too, so I was like, you know what, why not? Let's see. So pretty much with this wig, I had sewn this wig on my sewing machine, my Springer sewing machine. And also I got the length 20, 22, 24, 26. And it is, you know, I had to cut it just a little bit because at the end, it was kind of straggly, y'all. Y'all know how y'all had them ends when you get that very long hair, you're gonna end up cutting it anyway. So I kind of cut it to get it kind of even, you know. It is still pretty, it's still pretty long, you know. Let's get into the pros and the cons about this hair. Overall, I would rate this hair maybe a 6 out of 10 or a 7 out of 10. I'll do a 6 out of 10, a 6 out of 10. And the reason being, we're going to start with the cons of this hair. The cons of this hair, it doesn't hold a curl well, but I had to curl it like over and over and over just so it can kind of hold some type of, you know, bump. You can spray it to get that curl to hold, but me, I really don't really like spraying my hair with any type of holding spray or spritz sometimes, because sometimes I just wanted to kind of like fall like those cute little beach waves, you know, I be trying to go for. What's another con about this hair? Well, it's not really no cons. You know, all hair is going to shed. So, yeah, it did quite a bit of shedding, but not too much shedding. So, I really did like that. When I did read the reviews for FDX, people posted that, you know, it shedded super duper crazy. But it really didn't shed that crazy to me. It's normal shedding for chemically processed hair, which I kind of figured. Due to another con that happened, I got it as a body wave, but it ended up, after I washed it, it ended up falling pretty straight. Like I really had straight hair instead of body wave hair, but it's cool. Let's get into the pros of it. The pros, of course, it took lightener very, very well. I put 3 different developers just to get like some highlights and lowlights and the dimension in the hair. And I use a 20 volume, a 30, and a 40 volume developer. I use 2 different type of lighteners, which you'll see in the tutorial. And also, what else about this hair? And oh yeah, it was like, you know, it was cool. Oh, and another con, my bad, I meant to say, I know I switch back and forth, but another con about this hair, it was the closure. After I had lightened and tried to lighten the knots and get rid of them, it took a long time for some reason, which was kind of weird to me. And it took a little while for me to lay it, but eventually it laid and it looks fine. So, you know, you got to finesse it. I had to finesse it. Also, I think another reason why I didn't shed that bad is because, like, after I had lightened it, I made sure I deep conditioned and let it sit for, like, 3 to 4 hours. And I also use like some oil on it. So, you know, when you lighten hair, it automatically strips the hair. So you want to kind of to let it be moisturized and flowy, you know what I mean? Not too much oil, but just enough, you know what I mean? So yeah, it ended up coming out like this. And yes, y'all, you know, I just love it. I definitely love this hair. Let me know. We're gonna hop right into this tutorial. I hope you enjoy it. I'm gonna go step by step on how I did this whole process, And yeah, I love you, trendsetters. See you later.
Hey, trendsetters, welcome back to my channel. So today I am doing a hair review for FDX Human Hair. And I just wanted to see how this hair would do. I bought the bundles 22, 24, 26. And I did a 20-inch closure. The hair is super soft. The bundles are pretty thick, as you could tell. The wave pattern, it is body wave. I received the body wave. And it was actually on sale. And I think my total purchase ended up being $180. It wasn't the most expensive. So, you know, I'm trying to figure out how it's going to do after I lighten. So you're going to see me take like 2 scoops. And then I'm going to take the 30 volume developer and mix it in. And then all I'm going to do is stir it up real good. You want that toothpaste consistency, not too runny and not too thick. And you're just going to begin spreading it all over the closure so that you can take away those knots so they're not visible. That way, when you make your wig or you put your wig on, it looks just like scalp. So now you're going to see me rinse out the lightener from the closure. And I'm just going to put a little neutralizing shampoo just to stop it from processing. And I'm also going to put the Ion Cool Blonde just to tone down the brassiness in the closure. That way it can mellow out to a nice looking brown that matches my skin tone. So now you'll see me washing all my bundles. I love to co-wash my hair before I put it on my head because it's like, you know, when your hair is dirty, who wouldn't want fresh hair on top of their head? But I use some shampoos that I had, and because I want to make sure that everything looks nice and right. And I know it's not the most expensive, but I'm going to try to see if it's really 100%, you know. The way, while I was washing, the wave pattern did leave the hair, so it turned it out to be pretty straight. So yeah, it probably was chemically processed, which I wouldn't be surprised. But yeah, just continue watching the video. So now you're going to see me take the bundles that I have. I have 3 bundles, and I'm going to fold it in half. And when you get it, it should kind of already be folded. And you're going to place the bundles right on top of the other because you want to be able to have a flat, seamless bundle sewn into your cap so it can lay super flat. So I already threaded the machine. I will link the description below on how to thread a Springer sewing machine. That's where I learned how to do it. And pretty much you'll see me have the wefts close together. I will put the wefts under this presser foot. And I'm going to slide it under, as you can see. And once I slide the bundles under the presser foot, I lock it. And I'm going to begin to stitch. And you see, as I pull down that lever, it reverses. So I want to make sure that when I stitch it, it's not going anywhere. So I push it forward and push it backward just to make sure that the stitching is secure on the bundle. And like I said, you want to make sure that your wefts are up underneath each other as close as possible, because I promise you, it definitely makes a difference. And also take your time when you're doing this. It is not a race. You want to be able to have a seamless install when you are sewing your bundles onto your wig. And as you can see, I'm taking my time. I'm combing out those bundles because it can get, especially the longer and thicker the bundles, it can get a little tough sometimes. So like I said, take your time and just have patience. And that's with everything with life, y'all. Just have patience. You're going to get better and better as you continue to practice. And yeah. So at the end, I will stitch, and then like I did in the beginning, I reverse stitch so that it can have a secure hold. Then you'll see me lift up my presser foot, and I'll take it from there, and I'll take the scissors and cut the strings, and voila, you have your bundle sewn together super flat and right on top. So what you'll need is a dome head, which I have a 22, a flexible elastic wig cap. I also will have a metallic marker. I got that from Walmart. Also, you will need some thread and a needle so that we can sew our closure down. And you also need measuring tape. And I do the measuring tape for the simple fact to measure out my line so I know how far apart I will want my bundles. So now you'll see me take that wig cap and put it on the dome of the head. I'm gonna put it on just like I would put on my regular head, and I know already where to position. Then I'm gonna take that closure, and I'm just gonna begin to T-pin an inch above the hairline. And I'm also going to T-pin it in the back just to make sure that it's nice and flat before I begin to sew it down. So before I sew it down, I am going to braid it down so I can get the excess hair out the way. And I'm going to do both sides. I split it down the middle. And I'm going to just take my butterfly clip and just pin it up right before I sew down. So now I'm going to take my Sharpie and I'm going to take my measuring tape, and I'm gonna begin to go up the cap. And I'm using the tape because it helps me to get a pretty accurate measurement between the spaces, so it's like an inch apart. And I'm not gonna lie, it's kind of hard for me to hold the tape down and to do the make the lines, but I try to do it the best way I can and just make sure it looks nice and even. And yeah, so now you are going to see me sew down that very first bundle onto the line that I drew. I'm gonna put down that presser foot, and then I am going to begin to sew, like I said, reverse stitch and stitch so you make sure that it's securely on there. And I'm just gonna work my way up and make sure that you're keeping it flat and pressed out because you don't want any lumps or bumps. And just continue watching the video. So now you want to take the last track and sew it down around the perimeter of the closure, and make sure you cut your weft before you double weft and sew it down, just so you can see what you need left over to make sure it's seamless and laying flat. Now after you sew that last weft, it should look nice and flat. This is the inside of the wig, and what I'm going to do now is take some scissors and cut where the closure is and make sure you do not cut the strands because you don't want your wig to fall apart. And now you can see the final results of the wig made on your sewing machine. It's time to dive into this color, and I already pre-sectioned the hair off how I wanted to color it. What you'll need is a mixing bowl, and you'll need a color brush. You'll also need lightener. I use two different lighteners for this. I use the BW2 powder, and I also use the L'Oreal highlights. I think it's the L'Oreal baby bleach highlights. Well, Beach Baby Highlights. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all know it's in the store. It'd be like $20 for that little can, and they don't be even filling it up all the way. But it's cool. So I'm going to do like some different dimensions, highlights and lowlights with different levels of developer. I'm going to use a 20, a 30, and I'm also going to use that 40 volume developer. And it's going to definitely create some dimension. And y'all going to see of different browns, you guys. And y'all going to see exactly how it looks, and I just want y'all to continue to watch. This was a lengthy process. You also need some foil just so you can make sure it processes a little faster, and I use a comb just to comb out the hair to make sure it distributes evenly when I am applying the lightener onto the hair. After I rinse out the lightener, I am going to tone the hair. I'm going to use silicone mix by Avanti, and it is the bamboo, to make the hair soft and moist and have some type of life to it, so it won't be dried out. And I'm going to also use the Manic Panic in the color purple just to tone that brassiness to get it more lifted, more of a golden brown color. So you'll definitely see how it looks.
L.R. LRB.